Hey all, welcome to another Azure This Week. I am back hosting because Lars is lost somewhere in the internet. If you see him, let us know. This week, updates to Azure IoT Central, new Microsoft security certifications in beta, updates to Azure cost management and billing, and the month of Azure at ACG is happening right now. Also, registration for Microsoft Ignite is still open. This 100% online event of all things Microsoft is from March 2nd through March 4th, and it's completely free. Use the link in the show notes to register, and we'll see you there. If you're not familiar with Azure IoT Central, it is a fully managed, highly scalable Internet of Things software as a service solution. It's also a mouthful. It lets you monitor device conditions, create rules, and manage millions of devices and their data throughout their lifecycle, while also offering top-notch security along with regional availability, reliability, and the global scale of Azure. Updates to IoT Central include documentation improvements. There's no better way to learn a service than by reading its documentation. IoT Central documentation now has articles on how to use location data, how to use commands in a solution, and how to export data. The public API now lets you configure command timeouts. This is great news for all of you who are using IoT Central in your apps via API calls. And you can now use any and all filtering with the data export feature. Awesome. Let's move on to some certification news. Security, so important yet so overlooked. Luckily for us, Microsoft has introduced a few new security certifications. What a great time to learn! Ranging from entry level to professional level, no matter where you are at in your cloud learning, there is a shiny new certification you can take to build that skill set. Okay, so these certifications don't have the AZ at the start of it, like the AZ-900 or the AZ-104. That doesn't mean that the knowledge gained here won't help you with your Azure career. We all know security is at the top of a list for a successful cloud environment and project. So a few days ago, Microsoft released a few certifications, including the SC900, Microsoft Security Compliance and Identity Fundamentals, the SC200, the Microsoft Security Operations Analyst, the SC300, the Microsoft Identity and Access Administrator, and the SC400, the Microsoft Information Protection Administrator. Like I mentioned, they do not have Azure in their names, but if we dive into the outlines of these, for example, the SC300 lists multiple skills measured on Azure AD, the SC200 outlines Azure Defender, Azure Security Center, and Azure Sentinel, and the SC900 expects you to be able to describe security capabilities of Azure Firewall, Azure Bastion, and more. There is plenty of knowledge to gain when it comes to Azure if you plan on studying for any of these certifications. Now, do keep in mind, these are all in beta, so that means they are not scored immediately and are used to gather data on the quality of the questions and the overall exam. It does look like they are offering discounts for the first 300 people who register, so I'll make sure to add links to these certifications in the show notes. If you are going to take one of these, let us know in the comments. Let's now move on to some Azure cost management and billing updates. Microsoft has provided us with a few updates to Azure cost management and billing, which is the tool we use to manage our expenses in Azure. It's very important, and you should be familiar with this tool unless you don't care about money. If so, carry on. The updates include a new view called the Resource Groups view, which breaks down our costs by resource group and has an option to view nested resources and their charges. Views are a great way to quickly access information grouped by some sort of category, and the more views we have to pick from, the better. A small update, but a very much welcomed one. Cost management will now remember the last scope you were using, making it even easier to quickly pick up where you left off. And finally, several documentation and tutorials have been updated, including how to cancel subscriptions, how pricing works, and what to do if you have unexpected charges, which you wouldn't have if you watched my ACG Fundamentals video on budgets and billing alerts in Azure. Shameless plug. Be sure to check out the link in the show notes to check out all of these updates and learn something new. The ACG Heart Azure month is still happening. You can still take the AZ900 course. Last week, we did a walkthrough live stream on how to prepare for the AZ900 exam, including some practice questions and tips. If you missed it, no problem. Check out the recording using the link in the description. Lars has also recently put out a Cloud Guru Challenge where you'll get to build a continuously integrated global Azure app, and use services like Azure Pipelines, ARM Templates, Azure App Service, and more. We also have a few more Azure courses, and we keep adding more and more Azure goodies. Exciting times. Alrighty, Cloud Gurus, that's it for this episode. If you are a fan of Azure, make sure to give this video a thumbs up. If you want to keep up with all things Azure, make sure to subscribe to our channel. Keep being awesome, and I'll see you in the next one.